For this, I will be using my AOG stimulator board. It has a potentiometer that I can use to impersonate a wheel angle sensor. As I turn it left and right, notice the wheel angle changing. There is also a small CAN bus for connection to the Kia. Here, we will look at the PWM settings in AOG and observe their effect on the steering motor. The figure below the green tractor is the value, ranging from 0 to 254, that controls the speed of the motor. We are starting out with the sliders at their extremes and we will see what happens as we change them. The minimum to move is the lowest amount of PWM we can send that will actually start the motor moving. A 12-volt electric motor doesn't start moving at half a volt. It has a minimum power requirement to start moving. And you should set this figure to just below the amount that starts the motor moving. Of course, with Kia, the motor always receives 12 volts, so it can start driving with a much lower value than a traditional motor or hydraulic valve. If minimum to move is too high, the motor will always be moving and never stop. Again, this is difficult to illustrate with Kia, but you will easily notice it with a traditional motor. To set it accurately, engage drive mode with the green tractor, and use the yellow or plus 5 button to switch between dead ahead and 5 degrees and watch the wheels. Set min PWM to just before the wheels start to turn. The next setting of interest is proportional gain. It is the multiplier that controls the amount of steering error required to reach full speed. If it is too low, the tractor will take forever to turn to a distant line. If too high, it will weave back and forward across the line, constantly overcorrecting. Here we can see that with a low gain, we need to turn almost a full steering lock before the steering is at maximum speed. The tractor does not react quick enough in this case. If the gain is too high, it will steer too fast, constantly overcorrecting, and you will weave backwards and forwards across the line. Notice here we are making minor corrections off dead center, but the wheel is turning like crazy. We can also see how the output PWM is calculated. With a steering error of 30 degrees, a gain of 1 and a minimum to move of 20, the output PWM is 50.
1 times 30 is 30, add the 20 and you get 50.
If gain is 3, then 3 times the error, which is 30, makes 90, and add the minimum, which is 20, and you get 110. And finally, the maximum limit is, as you might expect, a figure that output PWM will never rise above.
You might use this to limit an overly fast motor.
And that's the end of this video. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and check the playlist regularly for new content. See you next time!